Sounds good.
Okay,
sounds good. I'm going to beat this customer up today, friends. He says I'm allowed to beat him up. So anyways, it's a snotty day, but it's not freaking horrible and blowing. It's calm, but it's wet. And we've got, here's the situation. There's a bit, we looked at it a couple weeks back. And I think we've added a couple, eh, Bob?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've added a couple on, so it's no big deal. We've got the time. And it's tight to the house, friends. And what I might do is do a time lapse with this thing underneath shooting up. Because we should do that. There you guys are. I think we should do that. So it's this one here. It's tight. It's small stuff, but it is tight. It's tight to the house. We got gutters, the whole gamut, the woodshed's here. So we're just going to get started. I'm going to get geared up. We're going to go for it. So there's these ones here. And then there's this big cup. There's a tall balsam here. And it's just going to be rigged to itself because it's actually the tallest tree. I could actually use this as a spar and rig this stuff out of the sky, but I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to climb each individual one because I don't have a ton of ground power here. I just got me and I got the homeowner, Bob. He's a very qualified guy, but he doesn't know the rigging program. So we're just gonna slide up them and slide down them and chunk them out. It's tight quarters, friends.
It's very tight.
Like, there's always 100 ways to skin a cat, right? We can climb the balsam and tip rig these and cut them out right at the ground. We could do all kinds of stuff like that. But I'm just going to shinny up them, get rid of them. So it'll be fun. It'll be a little climbing, a little top rigging here and there. I might even go up this balsam and slide down and grab this fir and then slide back into the balsam. Actually, I may do that, to be honest with you. Yeah, so we'll do that. We'll have some fun. Tallest balsam in this zone. That bigger balsam's back there. I could have used the balsam for everything, but I'm just going to use this for this set of three. Get them out of here. Again, friends, I stress, this is strictly for aesthetics only. That's all it is. So I'm just going to give the leather itself, I'll put a little open offs on there, and I'll just pull it through like this. And that'll put a little of the Obies on there. The Obi-Nobis, Obi-Wan Kenobi offs, right? For our Star Wars fans, Obi-Wans. That's it. So I'll just do that, I'll get that lubed up, and I'll bring you back when we're putting her on over a freaking Hootski.
We'll be right back.
thing. Clear. See, so you want to be on the, see this dog like this? You want to get spin around and get on the back side of it. It's way easier, friends. So just, gravity says do it. So I just slide over, right? This is for young climbers. I know you're watching out there, some of you. We're getting into small wood now. So you want to stay focused on what your picks are doing. I'll probably let it go right down in that foliage there. I may. Over the house. Over the house is probably more shock, but it'll come out easier, right? Oh, fucking might hang a false crunch today. Shock, you just kind of want to let it go, and the gutter's right there. So I think I'll just kick this out right there. That's what I'll do, and I'll rig it. I mean, look at us. We're literally rocking and rolling. Look at it. Good. So I'm gonna rig it. Yeah. We'll rig it down in here, and that'll kind of slow it down a bit, friends. Okay? So let's get set up. Now I've actually got, I haven't used it forever, because I got this little false crotch, but I'm not going to use that today. I'm just going to rig off of this thing here. I'll just rig off the tree, friends. Okay, so now we got our undercut in, friends, okay? Oh, we got a Dutchman. Oh, no, we don't. So that's going to go right in there. It's got enough force to get its way through the limbs. I'll show you. You want to try and get it going into its lean. So if you got to take a couple branches off, friends, take a couple branches off. So now, this setup, this little rope here, I can let run. I can literally just let it run. Okay, I'll show you what we do here. Rope coming down. So here we go, friends. So what I would do here is probably, you know what I mean, go here, go up, over top here, over this limb, behind this limb here, see, right like that, okay, and then I should probably, yeah, I probably should, go under my working end. So what that means is up over here, you see, and then, let's get rid of this stub. We don't actually need it there. They create problems. Okay, so, now, doesn't take much to, I got one there and one here. So, now, we go under the working end, which I don't really need to, friends, because of this. But what it does is it keeps it close to the tree, see? You see this? So I've just basically gone around the limb and I use the friction of the rope now. See? So that holds it to the tree. There's the rope running straight down. I'll move down a little bit. I may have to push the top off. And I don't have my handsaw with me, but that's what happens. See, it comes up now. Comes up here, okay? We just do, I like to throw a munter on it. I call it a munter, but every time I do that, I get in trouble by barbarists. A munter is a half hitch. It just takes up travel time. That just takes up a little travel time. And now I do my clove hitch here. Okay? So that's just what I do, friends. That's all I do. Where'd it go? Oh, there you are there. You see? So, around there. Here. Through here. Get your clove hitch set up. Okay, we're probably gonna have to push it off the tree because it's not, you see? And then I do a half hitch here just to secure the little top and to secure the knot. It's called a half hitch, secured. Hang it on a stub, we're ready to cut. There's our rigging. Now, this here acts as, it holds it there. This is actually, I could basically get behind it now, which I will, because I'll probably have to push it off, but I mean, we're moving. We're rocking and rolling here, friends, okay? So this is what I'll do now, and I'll have, I could even give my rope to the groundman. I don't got no gloves on. That was a mistake on my part, so we'll see here. We'll just let this, and believe it or not, it's gonna be heavy, but the foliage is gonna slow it down, friends, okay? So let's do it. Ready? Here we go. Natural crotch rigging. It's got one here and it's got one there. What happens? I'm just basically holding it there. I'm gonna push it off the tree now. And then grab the rope. Okay. See? There it goes. See? The brush. That's 4 inches right there, okay? So that's skinny, but I don't mind coming up here. I've been coming up here for years. It's just if you can use surroundings, you use your surroundings to take it easy on your shock, I recommend doing it. And I'm not Mr. Big Rigger guy with all the fancy rigging. I've never been. I use a rope. That's what I use right there. That's it. I always use one rope. I'll even tie in off one end and rig off the other. That's how I was trained by an old guy. Seriously, not an old guy, one of my best friends. But he'd been climbing right before. So we're gonna tie in, we're gonna go get rid of these couple little seeds inside. That one there, and then chuck this thing up.
3 bags full, it's all the same. We don't like it when we get caught.
Looking for somebody to blame.
Somebody to blame.
Yeah.
Let's do snap cut.
completely not.
With his long hair and his strong, unshaven face. His hands were cut and swollen from the poison of the sea. But his eyes were bright and clear. He hadn't changed. Stood in silence, trying to hide the desperation deep inside, to feel the joy of knowing he'd come back to me. But I checked myself, 'cause I knew by now it'd be enough.
Right? There it is. Boom. Top. Out.
And I just got to scoot up and grab that balsa, which I see, and just do a quick chunk out on it. 10-minute job. Okay, we'll chunk this thing out, guys.
People see him coming with a smile upon his face. There's always time for chit-chat as he stops to tie his lace. With Bertles back and dragging with two chords of the best, he feels you scrutinizing as he backs up to the test. Well, the woodman wears a smirk and flicks that whistle on his chest. He walks away in confidence, cause he knows his work's the best. He knows.
Friends, listen to the click on this old leather punch. Listen to the power of it. Listen. I love old tools. I freaking love them.